Hi there, here's how I changed my Unreal mannequin to a fully rigged mesh using AutoRigPro, Blender, and Unreal Engine 5.2. If you're not familiar with AutoRigPro, it's one of the most popular add-ons on Blender market. I would encourage you to purchase the full version, not the light one, because it has some features that would help you out in Unreal and Unity, like the FBX tool and the remap tool to target some of the animations. For this tutorial, I'm going to use a free character that you can get from Sketchfab. If you search for Fortnite, I'm going to use the Daredevil mesh. We're gonna go ahead and download it. Unpack the OBJ, and in Blender we're going to import the OBJ file. First thing that you should be aware of is some of the meshes that you're gonna import come in different scales or different sizes, or already have some sort of rotations applied to them. And it's best to just apply all transforms in the beginning. And then if in case your mesh is too large, you should get it down to somewhere around 180, 190 centimeters. If Blender is not set up to work in the metric system, you can go to your scene properties and change your length from meters to centimeters. Once you have your mesh, if you go to the ARP tab, you're going to see the smart option. Click on it, select full body, and we're just going to add the points like the neck, chin, or the shoulders. Try to put it as close to the middle point as possible. Same for the wrists. Try to eyeball it. Or the spine root, somewhere around here is fine. And the ankles. The way to set this up is similar to Mixamo or AccuRig. As I mentioned, AutoRigPro comes with some Unreal-specific options. For example, you can select the default preset to be the Unreal Engine 5 mannequin skeleton. And you can also choose the option to align your clavicles. Once that's done, if you don't have any sort of facial bones, if you don't need to do any facial setup, you can click the go button to generate the skeleton. Double check that the fingers are aligned correctly. If you're happy with your skeleton, you can go and click match to rig. This will create a control rig, and you can switch back to object mode, select your mesh first and the rig second. And now we're gonna do the skin weights. Click the bind button, wait a couple of seconds, and we're gonna check out to see how the mesh was skinned. Once done, switch to pose mode, grab one of the hands. And as you can see, there are some bad deformations underneath the arms. And I think in our case, it would be best to use the voxelized version of the skin weights. And go to pose mode. Try it again, and now we can see a much better deformation for your skeleton. Same thing with the legs. Also, don't forget to shade smooth your mesh in case it wasn't already. In case your mesh is not already in some sort of an A pose or something, if maybe it was in a T pose, AutoRigPro offers you a very quick and easy way to pose your mesh to the correct Unreal Engine 5 pose. All you have to do is go back to the Rig tab, and there you have a Pose tool dropdown. Just select Set Pose, and they already provide you with an A pose for Unreal Engine 4 and 5, and also a T pose if you need it for other purposes. Click OK, and it will automatically position your mesh correctly. However, this will not be the default pose that you're going to export out. If we come here to the Skeleton tab, and we can see that the rest pose is not our Unreal Engine 5 pose. But in order to fix that, all we have to do is just go back to object mode, select our mesh, and just duplicate the rig and apply the first one. Come back into pose mode, and here all we have to do is apply pose as rest pose, and this will automatically fix the rest pose. As you can see now, it is the rest pose. Now we can use the export option and select Unreal Engine humanoid. You can check the rig, see if there's any issues, and they provide you with a fix button as well. We can put in rename for Unreal Engine. We can add the IK bones and the animation IK bones, and we can also include the mannequin axis. That's about it. If you have animations, you can set them up here. For the mask, just leave the rig name as root, because that would be very helpful inside Unreal when we're doing the retargeting. Save the file as their devil rigged, or however you want to call it, in the same folder that the original textures and the original FBX was. And now in Unreal Engine, I just created a new third-person template with nothing in it. We're just going to create a new folder and call it just import. And this is where we're actually going to add our rigged FBS. Leave everything as the default. Don't worry about the issues that are related to the bills. Once everything is imported, you can drag and drop our skeletal mesh and check it out in the viewport. Now all we have to do is go back to our content folder, and there you're going to see a characters folder. Go to the mannequins and rigs, and inside you're going to find the RTG mannequin, which is the retargeting mannequin. Open this up. Select our skeletal mesh. And now you can see that because we already applied the Unreal Engine 5 pose inside Blender, it would fit perfectly with the one inside Unreal Engine. You can also move this out of the way a bit so we can see if the animations are working correctly or not. You can try out the MM stands for mannequin male. We can try out the idle one. And I think the MF stands for mannequin female. And for example, the run forward the walk forward is a bit more feminine, while the MM walk forward is a bit more masculine. Click save. Go back to the mannequins folders, go into the animations folder, and there you're gonna see the animations blueprint for the default third person mannequins. Select the ABP Manny and right click it. And we can now retarget our animation assets by just selecting our retarget mannequin. It automatically selects Manny and our new mesh. If you want, you can type in Manny for the asset names that you want to change and just put in your character name. Create a new folder for our retargeted assets. And do the retarget. Once everything is done, we can go back to our third person blueprint and select our rig and select our new ABP Daredevil. Compile and save. And as you can see, we have successfully updated our default character to a new mesh complete with animations and IK and pretty much everything else the default mannequin had. Thank you very much for watching this. If you like this video, I would appreciate a like or a subscribe. Share it with your friends. And see you in the next one. This happened the first time I tried. I don't know why it's saving. Like, it's just weird. And it really takes a long time to save. And now I realize that my tutorial is actually 10 minutes long. Anyway.